OmniTech is an American-based MSP. We're a multiple service provider. We provide IT support, telephone systems, especially specializing in VoIP, voice over IP services, and electronic security protection such as alarm systems, surveillance systems, and access control systems. Basically, we try to be your one-stop shop for all your technical needs, and we want to just keep you connected.
Good evening, hockey fans. I'm Harold Rose in here tonight for Javik Blake in the Mississippi Coliseum in the Wolves' Den for tonight's game between your Mississippi Seawolves and the Columbus River Dragons here in the Federal Prospects Hockey League. This is a rare Wednesday night matchup here in the Wolves' Den, and we're looking forward to it as the crowd is coming in. And the last game in this series was played back on March 1st, and all season, this game tonight is the 10th matchup between your Seawolves and the River Dragons. And so far in this series, the Seawolves are winless, and the Seawolves are giving up 6.6 goals in each of the contests, the nine contests leading up tonight. And your Seawolves are only averaging three goals in these nine contests, and this is below their 3.3 goal average of the season. Because overall, the River Dragons are averaging 5.3, and your Seawolves are averaging 3.8. And the River Dragons, who are leading the league and the conference here in the FPHL, they only have four losses this year, one of them coming to the Motor City Rockers, the two to the Carolina Thunderbirds, and one to the Zydeco out of Baton Rouge. And the River Dragons themselves were league champions back in 2021 and runners-up in 2022. So your Seawolves have their work cut out for them this evening. As I said, this is a rare Wednesday night contest. This is the second game in the series, and the third and final game will be here tomorrow night here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. But, of course, this won't be the end of the action. An action-packed weekend here in the Wolves' Den as your Seawolves will host the Baton Rouge Zydeco Friday night, and March 8th, Friday night here, we'll be celebrating St. Patrick's Day here at the Seawolves. It'll be Puck of the Irish here at the Puck Drop at 7:05. And once again, I want to welcome you to the Mississippi Seawolves pregame show as we're looking at face-off, the puck dropping coming up in about 15 minutes. Let's take a moment to hear from some of our partners here on Seawolves Feed.
So here at Gulf Coast Firestone, we specialize in your schedule maintenance, oil changes, tire rotations. We can special order any tire size you need, including we have some new trailer tires, ATV tires, and of course your regular car and truck tires. We also specialize in AC work, brakes, just about anything you need for your automotive repair.
Thank you. The oxygen is literally this is the process of charging the mitochondria and the cells in you, right? It's a lot deeper than it seems, bro. I want you to really try to focus here on letting go of your thoughts, right? Thinking's not really helping us right now. Think about to start here. The practice is really just letting go of thinking and just taking charge of really feeling. Just feeling what's going on and almost taking your judgment about what you feel out of the picture. You're just a state of witness.
Hey, what's going on, Mississippi Seawolves fans? It's number 23, Jackson Bond. I'm here with number 10, Philip Wong, and number 17, Kyle Russell. And we're here today at Gulf Coast Golf Carts in Biloxi, Mississippi. It's just off of exit 50. Come on out. They have new and used golf carts. They do services and repairs for any golf cart brand, so you can bring your own if you need anything fixed up. They're the people for you. Best prices on the coast, that's a guarantee. So come and see our friends. We appreciate all their support. We want to support them back. So come out and see them. Thanks, guys.
Now, once again, back here in the Wolves' Den. We are getting ready for the puck drop coming up in just over 8 minutes. And earlier, I mentioned the return of Wawrick here to the Seawolves. The Seawolves have been very busy with roster moves. If you were here last week for the ball game, for the hockey match, You know, the Seawolves struggled a little bit, particularly giving up four goals in the first period, but they were able to center themselves. But part of that's explained by all the changes in additions to the roster here for your Mississippi Seawolves leading into this final stretch of the season. Besides Wyrick returning to get into in between the pipes, Lucas Helland here will be coming back soon from his suspension, but I do not believe that he'll be back tonight. Dominic Martinock will be playing this evening. I saw him warming up down there in the number 34. We'll see what number will be on his sweater this afternoon. He's been added from the Blue Ridge Bobcats, coming from Carolina. The lefty comes and hails from Slovakia, and he's joined by the Canadian, Justin Portillo, the forward out of, he's out of Toledo, Ohio. And last time Justin Portillo saw action coming here was the Pure Huron in 21 and 22. And also he played with the Knoxville Ice Bears in the SPHL. And another roster move of recent, David Aslan was signed from the Baton Rouge Zydeco, who was a native of Montreal, Canada. And here is now in Biloxi as the Seawolves are getting ready to make a playoff run. The Seawolves are sitting in fourth place in the Continental Division, but with 15 games to go, they're in good shape with that 15-point lead, because out of those games, eight of those games, they're playing the Zydeco, which they match up well against. We've seen so far this season they are 9-4 against the Zydeco out of Baton Rouge. So Wolves fans, get ready for that playoff run, because hopefully we can see these Wolves in playoff action later here in this spring. It looks like they're bringing out the inflatable to get ready for the starting lineups. We want to take this opportunity once again to hear from some of our partners here at the Seawolves Network here in Biloxi, Mississippi.
Hey, Seawolves fans. It's Blake Wyrick, Phil Wong, and Matt Stoya here at Gulf Coast Firestone.
This is Matt Stoya with your Mississippi Seawolves at Gulf Coast Firestone, and just letting you guys know, we service all types of oil changes, AC, scheduled maintenance, brakes, front end repair, all types of tires for cars, trucks, ATVs, and trailer tires.
Hey Seawolves fans, all season ticket holders and sponsors get 15% off all services.
Open 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday through Friday, located at 4283 Pops Ferry Road in D'Iberville, Mississippi.
And don't forget to ask about our 6-month tire financing program. Only $149 down, minimal purchase, and you're good to go.
Here we go. Paintball Republic Seawolves down here. Woo! Having a blast. This is so intense. So much fun. So I can't wait to get back out there. Let's go. This is just kill.
Back here on the Seawolves Network, your Mississippi Seawolves are getting ready to come out. I see the officials in Hook back there getting ready for the pregame introductions. Puck drop is only 4 minutes away. The last time these teams met was back on March 1st. The Seawolves in that contest fell 7-2. The River Dragons were able to put it in the back of the net four times early in the first period, forcing the Seawolves to play from behind the rest of the ball game. And watching the film, I wasn't here to watch it in person. You know, it appeared the Seawolves pressed and they could never really get much going on in the River Dragons zone on their side of the ice. You know, the Dragons only lead by a differential of 5 here in the shots category. 40 shots were on goal for the Seawolves, and Shepard did a pretty decent job in the net that evening, but You know, the seven goals that were on the scoreboard didn't really add that, but the two goals of the night scored by your Seawolves were by Joaquin Nilsson and Hugo Koch. Koch was also given credit for an assist on the Nilsson goal. And also getting assists in the last game here in the Wolves' den, Philip Wong, Justin Barr, and Jackson Bond. And Bond also led the Seawolves in penalty minutes with six for a high-sticking double major and a roughing call. In the penalty category, we also had a 5 minutes in the box for fighting for Pinkowski, who, when the puck dropped to start the third period, things got underway. And let's turn it down to the ice for the introduction of your Mississippi Seawolves. All right, it looks like we're going to get a little bit more time here before the puck drops. You know, a little thinking about the game, the last meeting, the Seawolves did give up one power play goal on the evening. And, you know, they had a 66% power play kill. It was below their season average of 77%. But the Seawolves themselves failed to score on any of their power play opportunities, and we're hoping to see quite the improvement of that this evening. Now remember, tonight's game in the Wolves' Den is the only game on the slate tonight in the league, and these two teams will finish their series tomorrow night, which will also be the long Thursday night game, so all eyes of the league will be down here in Biloxi as your Mississippi Seawolves host the River Dragons out of Columbus. And I hear the Bronx cheers coming from the crowd as the River Dragons are getting on the ice. So let's get ready to meet your Seawolves.
Connor Lee! David Bunny by Junior. San Antonio, Texas, number 19, Patrick Sauter. At left wing, number 23, Jackson Bond. At center, number 10, Bella Wong. And right wing, number 74, LP Nielsen.
Now, a lot of the fans here tonight are real excited to see Wyrick come out, the inflatable, to get ready to get between the pipes. The crowd seems ready, and your officials for tonight's contest are Gary Glassman. Your linesmen are Gary Glassman and Jonathan DeSalle. Your referees are Dave Glassman and Chris Rowe. And now let's turn it back to the court for the ice for the national anthem. Hockey fans, as we're getting nearer to the drop of the puck, the crowd is getting excited. It is a midweek crowd here in Biloxi, and we look forward to seeing more of you guys coming out here on Thursday night. And the big Friday night game, remember, we'll be celebrating St. Patrick's Day. Saw the special sweaters, and you can look at them on Facebook. And I'm sure a lot of you guys will be interested in what's going to happen with those after the fact. But we're here, we are right now a little bit behind schedule. You know, some of these kids may be getting to school a little bit late in the morning as we're getting ready for some hockey. The third game in this series as your Mississippi Seawolves take on the River Dragons out of Columbus. Long as it center ice for your Seawolves. Let's get ready for the drop of the puck. And the Seawolves are sending it around. Now getting the clock started. Hopefully it'll catch up here and be a little bit behind as the River Dragons will push it into the Seawolves zone. It's on the back of the boards. Long misses the hit right there behind the net. Now the Seawolves are going to send it into the neutral zone, but the River Dragons are going to be able to get it and take control of it. And they're going to dump it into the zone, get a line change going on, coming onto the ice. Fresh sets of legs for the River Dragons. Stoya sends it across the ice and it bounces off the boards. River Dragons almost able to gain control of it. And the River Dragons are going to be able to keep it in the zone. But now the Seawolves are on the move in the neutral zone. Even numbers there as they dump it behind the net. Right there on the boards. Trying to get right there into the slot. But now a one-timer from the top of the zone. And the first save made by Lavalier. They battle near the net. Now they got a breakaway by himself, but the whistle is going to blow. It appears that McDonald was offsides. Both teams are going to change off the personnel. New lines on the ice. Dragons are trying to, and they are able to gain possession of the puck. And it looks like it's going to be another offsides call on the River Dragons. Right now it looks like both teams are filling each other out. And the Seawolves, hopefully they'll feed off of what Pinkowski did at the beginning of the third period in the last ball game and hopefully play a lot more physical this evening. And so far, it looks like we are seeing it. Now they're battling here on the near side of the boards. River Dragons are able to gain possession. It's now down in the T-Wolves zone. And they're switching the side. The T-Wolves get it. Now they're into the neutral zone. Trying to get around. Looks like everybody is going to be safe as Licio is going to be on the ice. Lind is able to push it back down into the River Dragons area. Seawolves. We have a big collision on the far side of the ice. Seawolves get possession. It looks like it's going to be one-on-one. Wong tries to get it to the middle, but the River Dragons yet are able to keep it from going into the zone. Here come your Seawolves into the Dragons zone down the right side, slashing. Oh, missed him right there in the slot. Had the opportunity there, weren't able to put the stick on the puck. River Dragons are gathering themselves, trying to get everybody on sides up here against the boards. Anderson is. Puck's behind in the crease, and now it's going to go all the way across, but it's going to be played by Lavalier. Seawolves right there with the aggression. Kuznetsov. Center ice. Dragons dump it down across, rolls across the boards. Looks like the Seawolves are doing a better job controlling the puck, and it looks like it's going to be an Omnitech icing call here. With that icing call, the faceoff is going to be down here on the near side from up here in the press box. McDonald and Barr in for the faceoff. The Wolves are able to control the ball. Stoya takes it behind the crease. Plays it off the boards. Here going in the middle, and the River Dragons are able to get possession of the puck. They're moving the puck around nicely. And they swing it out here into space. Almost right there. Moore had a chance, but it went over his stick. And the Dragons are there again. And in the slot, once again, Wyrick is able to put his glove on it, and it goes to the far side boards. And once again, at center ice, the River Dragons are able to take possession, and they dump it for a little bit of a line change. And they once again keep it in the zone. Now the Wolves are headed to center ice. Looks like they have numbers. And on the far side, on the stick side of Lavalier, They're not able to find the net. Now coming on to the near side is Licio, but the save is made. Good shot on goal. Licio was able to find some space. And the puck is going to be dropped. Wong has the opportunity to get the ball, but he gets tangled up by the defenders. Bond sends it up. Now wrist shot coming from the River Dragons. The goalie, one-on-one opportunity. And they're not in the save by Lavalier. The puck is still down in the zone. Oh, and that attempted pass is intercepted right there by Bond. Action here on the near side of the ice as the River Dragons are once again making that line change. As well, your Sea Wolves. Oh, almost were able to get that right there across the crease. That was Kuznetsov. Oh, it's some in the crowd there looking for some action from the referees and no call from the official. And now with the wrist shot right there in the house, but Ryrick is able to make the save. And that brings us to our first media timeout of the evening as we take an opportunity to hear from our partners here at the Sea Wolves Network.
OmniTech is an American-based MSP. We're a multiple service provider. We provide IT support, telephone systems, especially specializing in VoIP, voice over IP services, and electronic security protection, such as alarm systems, surveillance systems, and access control systems. Basically, we try to be your one-stop shop for all your technical needs, and we want to just keep you connected.
Welcome back to the Mississippi Coast Coliseum here in the Wolves Den on this Wednesday night game with 13:45 on the game clock. As after faceoff, we're headed towards, and the puck is going to be dumped. My apologies, fans, here on the live feed. I only got the call a couple of days ago, and if you possibly can't tell, I'm doing a rough job filling in for Yavik, as they usually call football and basketball, and getting my sea legs here in this midweek game here in the Wolves' Den. The action here, back down, here's the Sea Wolves. In their own zone, are not able to clear it out. Now they're able to get across center ice. They're not going to be able to get the numbers. The ball is going to be dumped in. That puck is going to be dumped in, and the River Dragons dump it out. Chased down right there by Asselin. And that's another OmniTech icing call. here in the Coast Coliseum. Going in for the face-off. It looks like it is going to be right down there wearing the 15, the sweater 15. I didn't think Lambert was playing, but no, maybe that is Anderson that I see. That is Anderson, the 25 on the sweater. The River Dragons are able to take possession down into the Seawolves zone. Here on the near side board, headed up the ice is Lynn. Looking for a person to pass to, and nobody finds any space there on the far side of the ice. Now coming back to Portillo, he's going to be able to put a shot on it, it looks like. We'll see how that's going to be scored. The Seawolves are able to... In the slunk hold, no, Lind had the opportunity there. Not able to close the deal. Now here come the Dragons. And a shot on goal. Wyrick with the save with his stick. And there's another shot coming from the center ice. And Wyrick once again is true to his job, doing a great job back in between the pipes. Here is Wyrick. Look at so far this evening, four saves for both of the goalies. Seawolves on the move. Find a man in space right there. That is Russell. Russell's able to get a shot off, but not get it close to the net. Now battling at the boards. Behind the goal line on the River Dragon side, and now they're coming trying to get numbers. We have a good hustle from Lynn to make sure they don't get those numbers, but now on the far side near the boards, the Dragons are moving the puck around on the breakaway. See, Wolf's trying, there's a shot from outside the slot, not able to find its way home. And the line change for the River Dragons. Kowski swings the puck around to the far side. Right there at the top of the house. A shot on goal by Stoya, but the save by Levalier. That's the fifth shot on goal tonight for your Seawolves. Right now they're being much more aggressive than the last time these teams met, because they seem to be and appear to be hungry to get on the board here in the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Once again, a shot there from the top of the house from Stoya. It is going to be blocked up by Levalier. Looked like we were going to possibly get some extracurriculars there in front of the net. But... And that is going not going to happen. Helen in there for the faceoff. River Dragons are able to take possession. They dump it down the far side of the ice. Swings around the boards. Now it's going to be jumped to the far side. Kuznetsov. Now it's going to be controlled right there at center ice by Doe. And that ball, that looks like it's going to be a flying biscuit headed into the stands off of Wyrick. And once again tonight, it seems like the River Dragons are spending more of the time in the Seawolves zone. but much better job by the Seawolves than the last outing. Now Dragons now near the goal line. Stopped there on the boards. And the shot blocked by Wyrick. That had the opportunity. Now the River Dragons now on the move. Jukes and Deeks around the defense, but the Seawolves are able to take possession of the puck. Now it's going to be back down to Blackwell and Wyrick with another save. So far, it looks like a very good outing back here on the ice in Biloxi by Wyrick. And this brings us to our next media timeout. Here, would you take the opportunity to hear from some of our partners here at Seawolves Hockey on the Seawolves Network.
What's going on, Mississippi Seawolves fans? It's number 23, Jackson Bond. I'm here with number 10, Philip Wong, and number 17, Kyle Russell. And we're here today at Gulf Coast Golf Carts in Biloxi, Mississippi. It's just off of exit 50. Come on out. They have new and used golf carts. They do services and repairs for any golf cart brand, so you can bring your own if you need anything fixed up. They're the people for you. Best prices on the coast, that's a guarantee. So come and see our friends. We appreciate all their support. We want to support them back. So come out and see them. Thanks, guys.
All right, back here. The action is about to happen on the ice. With the drop of the puck, the Seawolves are able to take possession of the puck. On the far side, Bond is looking for a place to go with it, and he's not able to find it. Good pressure from the forwards of the River Dragons. Now the Seawolves are able to get it out of the zone. Bond slashes down the right side of the ice, caught up at the boards. It'll be a scrum for the puck. Now the River Dragons are able to take possession of it. As they're pushing down, they got a breakaway. It's a one-on-one opportunity, and Wyrick once again with the save. And now it looks like if the River Dragons fans think the ball snuck into the puck as it came off the bar, but the referee was not able to see it. And once again, as we're getting excited for action, I forget to start the clock here online. The clock in the Coliseum is at 8:30. As we're now turn the action down. Lavalier plays it out. They're able to keep it in the offensive zone. Now the Dragons are able to clear it out. To organize their offense, dumping it deep may force the Seawolves to get their attack together here. Deep behind the goal line. A shot, once again, right there in the top, in the high slot. So far, right there, before we had that media break, there were already 7 shots on goal and 8 saves now in my book for Wyrick. We'll see how the statistician keeps it here. And now there's another Omnitech icing here in the Coliseum. Seawolves are gathering themselves. The officials are getting together. As they're going to discuss things over here at the box, they're going to try to work it out. I just know from up here in the press box, that last save by Wyrick, it was awful close to looking like it had bounced inside the crease or in the goal. But I don't know what kind of replay they might have available. It looks like action is about to begin again. 7:45 left in the first period of play. Zeros still on the board for the Seawolves and the River Dragons. And the puck is going to leave the zone as the River Dragons are going to have to tag out. There the Seawolves are able to steal the puck, get their offense organized, trying to get a breakaway there, dumping it. Helland is trying to chase it down. The Dragons are able to send it on the boards back into center ice. River Dragons getting their offense together. Pressure right there for Portillo. Quick line deep into the Seawolves zone. And it almost had a bad bounce off of Wyrick, but he's able to cover it up. And once again, the clock you see here online is going to be about a minute behind. This faceoff is going to happen to Wyrick's stick side. Your Seawolves look like they're able to maintain possession, and they are able to get it. But the River Dragons, they're on the attack, but the whistle blows from the linesman. It appears that's going to be our offside call. Face off here on the near dot to the press box. Officials are getting their story straight. Stoya now controls the puck, sends it to his left. Now it goes down the ice. And they're going to wave off the icing call. Fight for the puck here on the near boards. Controlled now by Barr. When the River Dragons are able to take possession of the puck. Find some space on the far side. Try to get it across the slot for the man that was there, but they weren't able to connect on that pass. A shot far from the outside. Wyrick looks to his right. Once again, right there in the slot, and the River Dragons are able to put one home here at the 6:03 minute, here in 6:03 mark here in the Coliseum. That'll be the first goal for the game this evening. That puts the River Dragons up 1-0 here with just over 6 minutes left in the first period. And on the face-off, the River Dragons are able to retain and keep possession of the puck. Going to trying to put something together here, all the Seawolves. And it looks like we got a flying biscuit here over the glass. For the River Dragons on that goal was Buckwell. Able to find the back of the net for the score. Just over 5.5 minutes left in our first period of play. Seawolves are trailing the River Dragons. The Seawolves are able to get possession out of that faceoff. Long did a good job. Back here to the near side to Lynn. Sends it back across the ice. Down into the zone. Trying to find a man in the slot. And able to get there. Lynn takes a shot from the top of the zone. Now able to find the back of the net. Wong fighting for the puck in the middle. Now the River Dragons are on the attack. Going to carry it around behind the net. Now you're near side, pass the puck off. Fight here at the boards. Now under 5 minutes left here in the first period of play. Seawolves are trying to clear the zone. Stick down on the ice. Now they finally get the clear, but the River Dragons are able to dump it back down so they can get their line change done. As now it looks like the pressure from the River Dragons is going to be relentless. The Seawolves are going to have to respond here. We've had a good number of shot on goals. We just haven't been able to find the back of the net. Trying to one-time it there from center ice. That was Kuznetsov. River Dragons are trying to attack with numbers. Get a man right there in the slot. Not able to get the pass to him. Plays it off the boards. Russell tries to send it around on the boards. Not able to get there. River Dragons are able to keep possession. Able to pass it down near the goal line. Tries to find Bersani in the slot, and they're able to get there. Now Bersani coming back around, trying to wrap it around. Wyrick is right there and covers it up. Once again, Wyrick is having a busy night back here in between the bars. And this break in the action, both of the teams are going to do a line change. Fresh legs on the ice. 3:34 left on the clock here, and that looks like it's going to bring us to our final media timeout of the period as we take this opportunity to hear from some of our partners here at Seawolves Network.
Literally, this is a process of...
Back here in the Mississippi Coliseum, your Seawolves trail the River Dragons 1-0, 3:34 on the clock. Wyrick has had a busy evening here. So getting ready for the faceoff after our third timeout here in the first period of play. And the River Dragons are going to dump it in. But Stoya is there to collect the puck as the Seawolves try to get their offense together. Portillo's not able to control the puck. The River Dragons put it center ice. One little man pushing up against the glass. They're going to have to get back on sides as they try to do that. Seawolves fighting here on the near side. Hard to see what's going on right down there in that scrum. Now pressing hard into the zone. Are the River Dragons getting a man right there in the slot? Wyrick reaches out and is able to wrap it up. Just breaking the action. The Seawolves and the River Dragons are going to be able to make the wholesale line change. They're going to be with Wyrick stick side here with the faceoff. The River Dragons are able to keep possession of the puck. Little wrist shot right there from the top of the house. Seawolves looking for a whistle, and they are not going to get it. Wyrick was pretty upset about that lack of call. And now we are going to see a whistle, and it is going to be a power play here at Gulf Coast Firestone Power Play. As we're going to see a River Dragon into the penalty box. Look like from my studying of the signals, it looked like a slashing call. I'll let you know when I hear the PA here in the Coliseum what it was. It looks like a 2-minute minor penalty. The Seawolves here on the Gulf Coast Firestone power play. It should run out most of this first period. The call was tripping is what gives the power play opportunity for your Seawolves. And that puck goes up in the air in the slot. Now the River Dragons are going to try to get it out the zone, and they successfully get it. And now the River Dragons look like they're going to try to just get back to center ice. Going to be aggressive on their shorthanded goals here. That is one thing that we're looking up, the Seawolves are actually have one of the best records of shorthanded goals in the league. But now we're trying to get this power play. A minute left in the power play. That's your Gulf Coast Firestone power play. Now here come your Seawolves into the zone. Bond with the puck. Gets around one guy. Tries to get the pass to the middle. The pass was blocked right there by Anderson. Now the Seawolves set up again. Get it on the space. Asselin shot wide of the net. Just under 40 seconds left in the power play. Once again, the wrist shot is wide of the net. Lavalier didn't even have to make an attempt with his glove to stop that. Now only 20 seconds left in this Firestone power play. The Seawolves are gathering themselves. 33 seconds left here on the clock at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Dumping it down as Kuznetsov. The far side of the ice, trying to find a man. And the River Dragons were able to successfully kill that power play. Now that flying biscuit, 19.4 seconds left on the clock. Here in the first period of play. I can see the Zamboni coming here, getting ready for its job here in just a few seconds. Face off to Lavaliers, right? Now a wrist shot coming from the backside of the zone. And that icing call is once again an Omnitech icing call here with 8.4 seconds left on the clock. Yeah, I know it says triple zeros here on YouTube, but there's 8.4 seconds left. With a faceoff to the stick side of Lavalier. Seawolves see if they can make something happen here in the last waning seconds. And the River Dragons are able to take possession of the puck and dump it into the zone. And Wyrick is going to send it out. And that brings the horn to conclude your first period here this evening with the score. The River Dragons 1 and your Seawolves 0. You know, looking at the scoreboard, you can see Wyrick here on his first night back has had a lot of work. The River Dragons have 14 shots on goal. He's had 13 saves on the evening. As we're going to take this opportunity here in this break in between periods, let's hear from some of our partners at the Seawolves Network.
Seawolves fans, it's Blake Wyrick, Phil Wong, and Matt Stoya here at Gulf Coast Firestone.
This is Matt Stoya with your Mississippi Seawolves at Gulf Coast Firestone, and just letting you guys know, we service all types of oil changes, AC, scheduled maintenance, brakes, front end repair, all types of tires for cars, trucks, ATVs, and trailer tires.
Hey Seawolves fans, all season ticket holders and sponsors get 15% off all services.
Open 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday through Friday, located at 4283 Pops Ferry Road in D'Iberville, Mississippi.
And don't forget to ask about our 6-month tire financing program. Only $149 down, minimal purchase, and you're good to go.
Here we go. Pinball Republic Seawolves down here. Woo! Having a blast. This is so intense. So much fun. So I can't wait to get back out there. Let's go. This is just kill. Kill.
Back here during the intermission, I'm Harold Rose, and once again in for Yavik Blake on the Seawolves Network here live on YouTube as your Seawolves are hosting the River Dragons out of Columbus. So far after one, it is River Dragons 1 and your Seawolves yet to score. The story of the first period, though, are the 14 shots on goal from the River Dragons. And back in goal for Wyrick is Wyrick, and he has done a really good job of facing this onslaught, it appears, coming from the River Dragons offense. And it's easy to see as a casual fan why the River Dragons only have 4 losses on the season. And your Mississippi Seawolves, they were able to get some offense going there, a few attempts to put the puck in the back of the net. 8 shot attempts, 8 official shot attempts for your Seawolves. And a few of them were very wide, but they were going to get there. But Lavalier has done a wonderful job this evening. And we are looking what's happening going forward. Let's hear again, once again, from some of our partners here at Seawolves Hockey on the Seawolves Network.
So here at Gulf Coast Firestone, we specialize in your schedule maintenance, oil changes, tire rotations. We can special order any tire size you need, including we have some new trailer tires, ATV tires, and of course your regular car and truck tires. We also specialize in AC work, brakes, just about anything you need for your automotive repair.
We have built great relationships with not only the players, the staff, and everything that to do with the team. We've also built great relationships with other sponsors. One of the things we incorporated this year and we plan to keep moving forward with is a discount to other sponsors. And some other sponsors have now jumped on board and are offering discounts to us and other sponsors as well. So it's just building another community of networking for business networking. And I believe it's helping grow small businesses here on the Gulf Coast.
All right, as we have a few fans here in the bleachers up doing the Cupid Shuffle, once again, you know, the score, the River Dragons 1, your Seawolves 0. We were finally able to get it updated on the online feed there to show the goal. And at one point there, about the 9-minute mark, there looked like there should have been another goal because the radio crew for the River Dragons are up here in the press box. And from our angle, that puck looked like it crossed that goal line. But the official was standing right there, and he has the best view of it. And so your score here, if after 1 period of play, your Seawolves 0, the River Dragons 1. And now here in a game like this, you know, the Seawolves, when you think about the positives from this first period, very much different from the last time these teams met. When the first period ended, the score was 4-0. The Seawolves are in a good spot with only allowing 1. Wyrick, once again, has done a great job in between the pipes here this evening with 14 saves. The Seawolves have had a tough road to hoe here with this homestand against the River Dragons. But once again, remember, there's only 15 games left in the season. And out of those 15, the Seawolves are going to be taking on the Zydeco several times, 8 out of those 15 games. Zydeco is in last place in the Continental Division as your Seawolves are trying to hold on to fourth place with a 15-point lead in the standings. Now, looking forward to the second period, the Seawolves are going to have to put more pressure on the River Dragons defense. They're going to have to move well, find space in on the ice in the River Dragons zone. They've got to find some open areas. And when they have that opportunity, they're going to have to take advantage because the River Dragons defense and La Valliere are pretty stout. They are going to absolutely have to capitalize when they have the opportunity. They're going to have to play their best hockey they can play here for the next two periods to even this match up and get in the lead, as we hope they will do here in the Mississippi Coliseum. And we want to take once again to hear from some of our partners here at the Seawolves Network live on YouTube.
Hey, what's going on, Mississippi Seawolves fans? It's number 23, Jackson Bond. I'm here with number 10, Philip Wong, and number 17, Kyle Russell. And we're here today at Gulf Coast Golf Carts in Biloxi, Mississippi. It's just off of Exit 50. Come on out. They have new and used golf carts. They do services and repairs for any golf cart brand, so you can bring your own if you need anything fixed up. They're the people for you. Best prices on the coast, that's a guarantee. So come and see our friends. We appreciate all their support. We want to support them back, so come out and see them. Thanks, guys.
Welcome back to the Mississippi Coast Coliseum here as the Mississippi Seawolves take on the River Dragons here in FPHL play. And the dance cam was just going on here in the Coliseum, and we've had a little bit of technical difficulties. The Zamboni has not been able to make its way out onto the ice yet, as it appears they're having to do some work down here on the what would be the outright. When you look at the screen, the goal, they're working on trying to get the pipe going. So, you know, if you're watching this game and you're a fan of hockey, checking online right now in the third period, the Sabres are all knotted up 1-1 against the Maple Leafs. And yet to begin the yet tonight, they'll be coming on at 9:30 Eastern. The Red Wings are going to take on the Avalanche and also the Senators and the Ducks. That game is going to start at 9 o'clock Central Standard Time. But right now, it appears they won't show the camera down there with one man doing the work and about seven people standing around. It looks like a good government gig that I need to get, as they try to get this straightened out so they can send the Zamboni out here. It looks like it's going to delay some of the action here as the officials are coming out to begin the second period. But let's wait and see what's going to happen. So we're going to once again take this opportunity to hear from some of our partners here at Seawolves Hockey.
Seawolves fans, it's Blake Wyrick, Phil Wong, and Matt Stoya here at Gulf Coast Firestone.
This is Matt Stoya with your Mississippi Seawolves at Gulf Coast Firestone, and just letting you guys know, we service all types of oil changes, AC, scheduled maintenance, brakes, front end repair, all types of tires for cars, trucks, ATVs, and trailer tires.
Hey Seawolves fans, all season ticket holders and sponsors get 15% off all services.
Open 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday through Friday, located at 4283 Hops Ferry Road in D'Iberville, Mississippi.
And don't forget to ask about our 6-month tire financing program. Only $149 down, minimal purchase, and you're good to go.
Here we go. Paintball Republic Seawolves down here. Woo! Having a blast. This is so intense. So much fun. So I can't wait to get back out there. Let's go. This is just kill.
Back here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum, the Zamboni is just able to get out there as we're waiting on the second period to start. Right now, the Columbus River Dragons have a 1-0 lead over your Mississippi Seawolves. The clock is counting down with under 1 minute to go, but the Zamboni is just now getting started with his laps around the ice. So it looks like we're going to have a slight bit of a delay here at the Mississippi Coliseum. Now that the Zamboni is finally making its way around the ice, the Twisted T Zamboni, the fans and the kids are pretty excited. And we are going to see what the clock gets set back to here as it winds down here as the officials have come out and have been over talking to the scorers table. Let's see what they say here and what the clock gets set at as Zamboni tries to get his job done. And see if they're going to wave it off here as the clock ticks down to zero. After one full period of play, Columbus River Dragons 1, your Mississippi Seawolves yet to score. And we're going to hopefully see more scoring opportunities for the Seawolves here, but they're going to have to get it out of their zone and control the puck better in the River Dragons zone. They weren't able to move the puck around effectively to see a lot of good open shots. But also the River Dragons defense is moving quick to the puck. They're able to look at the plays ahead of time. So when we figure out what time we're going to come back, let's go once again to hear from some of our partners here at Seawolves Hockey.
When injury knocks you out, Bienville Orthopedic Specialists will be there for you every step of the way. We are here to get you back, back in the game, back in motion, back to your life. Our elite team of orthopedic specialists will work side by side with you, educating you about your treatment plan, utilizing advanced technology, and providing you with a successful path to recovery. Bienville Orthopedic Specialists, we will get you back.
So here at Gulf Coast Firestone, we specialize in your schedule maintenance, oil changes, tire rotations. We can special order any tire size you need, including we have some new trailer tires, ATV tires, and of course your regular car and truck tires. We also specialize in AC work, brakes, just about anything you need for your automotive repair.
OmniTech is an American-based MSP. We're a multiple service provider. We provide IT support, telephone systems, especially specializing in VoIP, voice over IP services, and electronic security protection, such as alarm systems, surveillance systems, and access control systems. Basically, we try to be your one-stop shop for all your technical needs, and we want to just keep you connected. We have built great relationships with not only the players, the staff, and everything to do with the team. We've also built great relationships with other sponsors. One of the things we incorporated this year and we plan to keep moving forward with is a discount to other sponsors. And some other sponsors have now jumped on board and are offering discounts to us and other sponsors as well. So it's just building another community of networking for business networking. And I believe it's helping grow small businesses here on the Gulf Coast.
Hey, what's going on, Mississippi Seawolves fans? It's number 23, Jackson Bond. I'm here with number 10, Philip Wong, and number 17, Kyle Russell. And we're here today at Gulf Coast Golf Carts in Biloxi, Mississippi. It's just off of exit 50. Come on out. They have new and used golf carts. They do services and repairs for any golf cart brand, so you can bring your own if you need anything fixed up. They're the people for you. best prices on the coast. That's a guarantee. So come and see our friends. We appreciate all their support. We want to support them back. So come out and see them. Thanks, guys.
Here we go. Paintball Republic Seawolves down here. Woo! Having a blast. This is so intense. So much fun. So I can't wait to get back out there. Let's go. This is just kill.
All right, fans, once again, welcome back to the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. As your Mississippi Seawolves host the Columbus River Dragons. Right now, after one period, the River Dragons have one goal. Your Seawolves yet to score. Now, on that one goal, only assist was Justin McDonald. And he right now, he holds a lead record for a 30-game scoring streak. And in that streak, he's had 24 goals and 44 assists and 68 total points. But as we look at that, that looks like the committee is back down trying to get the net back on the ice here on the far side that you can't see in the live stream. It looks like we're going to have a little bit more of a delay. You know, and this being me being a rookie up here calling this game, hopefully you fans can tolerate it a little bit, but you know, you also could be up here with a great view and appreciate the beauty of this game and just with the speed and the quickness it goes back and forth, the quick line changes. And you know, I'm learning about what's happening when the ball is when the puck goes through the slot. Man, it goes through there lightning fast, and if you don't get a stick on it, redirect it to get it in the goal, there will absolutely be a defender there. And that's what the Seawolves have run into tonight against the River Dragons. Their defense is exceptionally quick, and the Seawolves have very much to be thankful for tonight, especially with Ryrick back in the net here for your Mississippi Seawolves. He has returned from his injury. He was able to come across with 13 saves after the 14 shots on goal by the River Dragons in the first period. Now the Seawolves, when they came out and opened the ball game, you could tell they came out purposely to be physical. And I'm looking forward to see if Coach Skinner is going to emphasize that here in between periods, and if that's what the Seawolves are going to come out and do. You can see him lined up, itching to come out here in the tunnel on the far side of the rink. It looks like we may get the goal back on its post. And it looks like we're going to get some more hockey here in the Mississippi Coliseum here on the Seawolves Network. The skaters are waiting to come out here and get a little warmed up because this has been a long break. So let's once again take this chance to hear from our partners here on the Seawolves Network.
Seawolves down here. Woo! Having a blast. This is so intense. So much fun. So I can't wait to get back out there. Let's go. This is just kill.
When injury knocks you out, Bienville Orthopedic Specialists will be there for you every step of the way. We are here to get you back, back in the game, back in motion.
So here at Gulf Coast Firestone, we specialize in your scheduled maintenance, oil changes, tire rotations. We can special order any tire size you need, including we have some new trailer tires, ATV tires, and of course your regular car and truck tires. We also specialize in AC work, brakes, just about anything you need for your automotive repair.
Hockey fans, the teams are back on the ice. It looks like they're done warming up. The officials are here. The River Dragons appear ready to go. Well, the referees are able to get the squeegee out, get the mess cleaned up behind that net where the staff was having trouble getting it off the post. Wyrick now is headed to your right. Your Seawolves this evening in the red home jerseys with the red pants. Bond is skating around center ice, bobbing his head. It looks like he's ready to go. And I know all the fans here are looking for a lot more energy coming from the Seawolves. Put a little pressure on the River Dragons here in the second period of play. And in that first period, the Seawolves had one power play opportunity at Gulf Coast Firestone power play, and they weren't able to capitalize. Let's see what can happen here in the second period. Long in the faceoff, but the River Dragons are able to control the puck. Right across center ice. Stoya with the puck, feeds it to the far side of the ice, into the zone. Bond is knocked down right there on the boards. The puck ball goes to the far side, and the River Dragons are not able to clear the zone. Seawolves are able to keep it in the zone. And a little quick wrist shot coming from Wong, but able to be covered up by Lavalliere. First shot on goal as we get started. We're 19 and a half left as the clock on the online feed catches up. Into the faceoff circle goes Barr. Near the Lavalliere's right. River Dragons try to clear it out, and it stays in the zone. Coming in for a big hit. The puck is up against the wall. Time for it. Asselin's able to keep it in the zone. Pushes it into the corner. The offense stays put. But the River Dragons are able to get possession of the puck, and as they're headed to center ice. Defenders are able to hustle back to keep the breakout from going. Line change coming up. River Dragons have a chance right there. Weak line is able to get a shot off. And in space again. River Dragons, and it slides across right there. Dangerous territory just top of the crease. The battle is for the puck here. Kuznetsov carries it down into the zone. Now with the puck, Underwood. on the near side. Looks like the River Dragons filling it out, trying to find some space in the slot. Pushes it, and the pass is blocked. Well done there in the middle. That was Wong blocking the pass. River Dragons were not able to get off another shot. Right there in front of the crease. Wyrick is able once again to avoid the puck going in the back of the net. Right there, Hunter once again feeds him in the slot. McDonald, he's not able to get a shot off. Now the shot from the circle. The River Dragons are able to get back on side. Seawolves trying to clear the zone. They're not able to do so. Right there in front of the crease again. And it is going to be wristed in right over the glove. Right there into the three hole. That was McDonald on the goal for the River Dragons. That goal was at the 17-minute, 6-second spot. You know, Wyrick is trying to withstand the storm, but there is a lot of pressure as the Seawolves have not been able to clear the zone. Now comes some pressure from the Seawolves, but Lavalier with the block. It appears Wyrick appears to be under attack here this evening in the Mississippi Coliseum. The crowd wanted a tripping call, and they are not going to get it. Bond controls the puck, tries to set up the Seawolves offense. Crosses center line by himself. He's going to try to do it himself. He goes into the crease, and he's not able to put the shot home. Right there in the slot. It looks like it's Bond. No. Lavalier is able to keep the puck from finding the back of the net. Columbus is able to get it down into the zone. Stoya gets the puck, takes it behind the net. Trying to find some space. The River. Now it's just going to be dumped into the zone as we see a quick little change coming for the forwards. Excuse me, the defenders. They're not able to keep the puck in the zone for long. And now, once again, the defense is under attack. Racing for the puck is Bersani. He's able to get there and keep it in. Look for the slap shot. Blocked by the defenders. Now that pass is going to be intercepted. Kuznetsov able to get it into the zone, but now it's out of the zone again as the Seawolves try to set up the offense. Kuznetsov into the zone, looking for some space. Not able to find an open teammate to get the pass to. Mars there in the mix, sends it deep into the zone, and Columbus with the line change. Fighting for the puck here on the near side. Coming in, Asselin. Getting in there. Oh, I'm sorry. That was Lissio. And the pass is going to be blocked. And now the Seawolves are going to try to get it out of the zone. But Columbus is able to keep it in the zone. And now it looks like the Seawolves are in business. Lissio is able to get the pass off. Deeks it around, but the whistle is going to blow. We're at 14:20 here in the second period of play. Your Mississippi Seawolves 12, Columbus, the River Dragons 2-0 here on the Seawolves Network. Here from the Mississippi Gulf Coast Coliseum.
When injury knocks you out, Bienville Orthopedic Specialists will be there for you every step of the way. We are here to get you back, back in the game, back in motion, back to your life. Our elite team of orthopedic specialists will work side by side with you, educating you about your treatment plan, utilizing advanced technology, and providing you with a successful path to recovery. Bienville Orthopedic Specialists. We will take you back.
All right, back here in the Coliseum, your Mississippi Seawolves trail the Columbus River Dragons 2-0 here on this Wednesday night ball game. Now, in the official message here, I only see two shots on goal, but from up here in the press box, it seems like Wyrick is just under attack down there in the crease. But out of those two shots, one was able to find its way home. Now Wong is able to win the faceoff, and the Seawolves dump it in. And the River Dragons are able to send it on the boards. McDonald trying to chase it down. Stoya tries to get it out, but the River Dragons are able to keep it in. A shot from the top of the zone. Wyrick is able to stop that from finding home. Once again, another shot from deep in the zone, and the River Dragons are able to maintain possession. Hunter down there fighting for the puck. Seawolves there in the scrum. Oh, no, open shot. Hunter right there. Wyrick comes out, makes a great play off his stick into the far side, and now it's into the River Dragons zone. Seawolves got caught mid-change, but they're able to get possession of the puck. Head bar puts a shot, and it's not going to find its way. Bar still now fighting in the corner. Coming in is Kuznetsov, trying to give an open pass. Quick shot from the high slot right there by Helen. And the puck... finds its way past the goal line, and that's another Omnitech icing here this evening in the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. This faceoff is going to happen to Lavalier's right. Mars headed into the circle. And the faceoff, let's see if the Seawolves can get something happening here. And the Seawolves lose possession of the puck. And another shot on goal for Columbus. The Seawolves are having a tough time keeping possession of the puck this evening. And Columbus is going to town on that shot. Slohitka with the shot, but the save by Wyrick. 12:38 on the clock here in the Coliseum. Face off to Wyrick's left to his glove side. Seawolves get the puck. Headed down into the zone is Licio. He passes it to his right, and they're able to get it off, but the block by Lavalier. Fed back into the zone by Anderson. Poking around in the crease, and a little extra work there coming from Sohetka on Anderson. And the officials sorted out. So that was Portillo down there in the scrum where it looked like the extracurricular activities were going to get started. Face off to the right of Lavalier. Anderson is not able to, and the Seawolves are able to get a shot off. Anderson does near the blue line. Still looking forward and hoping to get to see a little physicality from the Seawolves. Lind gets the puck. off to Stoya. Now across the center line is Licio. And he's going to put one of the puck sitting behind the net right now. Trying to bend it around, but with the two forwards on there, they're only get there. Stoya is able to poke the puck away. The opportunity there from Storjahan, but Stoya did a nice job of playing defense. Now, once again, a lot of pressure here behind the red line. The Seawolves are able to clear the zone. Now on the far side of the ice, Columbus just dumps it in. Seawolves on the move, but they're not able to do much with it as they dump it into the zone. And Anderson for Columbus is able to get the puck. Oh, that had the chance of being an on goal there, but it worked out for Columbus. Now Columbus with even numbers on the attack. Trying to wrap it around. Under 11 minutes. And Ryrick with another save for the evening as the fans are giving their support for him. Both teams are going to do a line change, it looks like. Or at least the Seawolves are. So here, 10:46 left to go in the second period. Your Mississippi Seawolves trail Columbus 2-0. Trying to get some offense going here. The Seawolves are playing too much time on their part of the ice. Too many opportunities for the River Dragons, and they've been able to capitalize twice. Trying to get their offense together, finding some space, not able to control the puck. It's going to end up deep in the zone, and that's going to be an Omnitech icing call. Here are 10:18 left to go in the second period. Columbus with the wholesale change. The faceoff will be to the stick side of Lyric. It's really important here that the Seawolves get possession of this puck and clear the zone. Helland with the puck. And finally, out of the zone. And there's not going to be any whistle from the official. So now we're going to be trying to slow down this River Dragons attack. Columbus has been relentless this evening. Hasselin's pass is intercepted by Columbus. Trying to find some room right there in the center ice was Andrioli. Defensive change for the Seawolves. And quickly, McDonald has the puck deep in the zone. The slap shot from the blue line. And the opportunity right there in the slot. But once again, another great save by Weirich. With 9 minutes left to go in this period. This will bring us to our second media timeout to hear from some of our partners here at Seawolves Hockey.
Hey, what's going on, Mississippi Seawolves fans? It's number 23, Jackson Bond. I'm here with number 10, Philip Wong, and number 17, Kyle Russell. And we're here today at Gulf Coast Golf Carts in Biloxi, Mississippi. It's just off of exit 50. Come on out. They have new and used golf carts. They do services and repairs for any golf cart brand, so you can bring your own if you need anything fixed up. They're the people for you. Best prices on the coast, that's a guarantee. So come and see our friends. We appreciate all their support. We want to support them back, so come out and see them. Thanks, guys.
Once again, welcome back to the Coliseum. The kiss cam is on as the crew here at the Coliseum trying to get the officials going. And they are going to politely decline. The Seawolves have to find an answer to this relentless attack from Columbus. They have not been able to spend much time in their offensive zone. Now the clock here in the Coliseum is reaching 9 minutes. Your Seawolves yet to score this evening. Columbus River Dragons with two. Wolves are able to keep it in the zone. Works across. Not much help there. Not much help there for Licio. And so now the River Dragons are able to get possession of the puck. Columbus is moving up the ice. Trying to find some space in the middle. Finds a man with open area right there. That was Petronio. Petronio had the open shot, was left alone on the ice. Puck is going to be dumped into the zone. Chased down by Bond. Lynn calls for the putt. Doesn't have a chance to get the shot, but he dumps it to Stoya, who does get the shot off. And the save is eventually going to be made on the rebound by Lavalliere. With 7:42 left to go in the second period, the Mississippi Seawolves trail the Columbus River Dragons 2-0. Now that the puck is down in the River Dragons side of the ice, let's see if the Seawolves can keep it there. Long in the faceoff. Seawolves are not able to get possession. Wick line headed down, tries to swing it to the far side of the ice. And there's a flying biscuit here in the Coliseum. The faceoff coming up here at center ice after the puck heads into the bleachers for a souvenir for one of the fans here. I'm waiting to get an official count on the attendance this evening. We'll see what we get. But here at the midweek game, it's good. We're looking forward to a lot of these fans coming back out tomorrow night here to the Coast Coliseum for the Thursday night game for the final game in this matchup against the River Dragons. Columbus with another shot on Wyrick, but he's able to cover the puck up, make the save.
All right, how we feeling? Let's do it.
The face-off will be coming up to Wyrick's right. That'll be the 10th shot on goal this period for Columbus. Waiting on the puck to drop, and McDonald is able to win the faceoff as Columbus sends it into the corner. Trying to find a slasher going across the middle, but they're going to send the puck back around the boards. Right there is Kuznetsov trying to get possession of the puck, and now Seawolves trying to get into business, but it doesn't make its way around. Now they're trying to peel around the net. Finally, out of the zone, a little breathing room for the Seawolves. Barr in pursuit, trying to keep the puck in the offensive zone, but now it's back down in the Seawolves zone. Nielsen, active defense now. is going to be 2-on-3. The ball, the puck is going to be dumped. I don't know if the scorekeeper will count that as a shot, but Lavalliere covers it up. Faceoff coming up to Lavalliere's right. Anderson in for your Seawolves. Let's see if we can get something out of this opportunity here. Oh, kicked out of the circle. Is jumping off. And now Stoyak with the puck. With the wrist shot over the top of the net. Now 6:06 on the clock here in the Coliseum. Good to see the opportunity as the Wolves keeping the puck in the offensive zone. Now the Dragons are able to get possession and put it down in the center ice. Looks like it's going, we're going to see an opportunity for a line change here for your Seawolves. Under 6 minutes left to go in the second period. Your Seawolves trail the River Dragons 2-0. Five and three quarter minutes left. Weirich is able to cover up the loose puck. Faceoff is going to be on the stick side for Weirich. So far in this period, no power play opportunities for your Seawolves. As the River Dragons have only had that one penalty. The Seawolves had that one power play opportunity and failed to put the puck in the net. Now a little movement there for the Seawolves. Nielsen dumps it past the net. Wolves are able to keep it in the zone. Nielsen with the pressure. Wong chasing down the puck, but Columbus is able to get it out of the zone. They settle things down. Looks like they're going to keep it here at center ice so they can get the opportunity for a line change after they dump it in. The Wolves are going to try to catch him on the change. Bond on the near side. Dumps it in. Kuznetsov. There. Bar on the far side of the ice. Not able to maintain possession of the puck. The pass is going to be intercepted by Aslan. And the Wolves lose possession of the puck again. Now on the right side, the shot. Top of the from the blue line, the puck bounces into the air, into the corner. Up against the board. Man, wide open in the high slot. Not able to put it home. We'll see if Weirich gets credit with the save there. Did have a small opportunity there. Kuznetsov. They're with Helen, but they're not able to put the puck home. Quick wrist shot blocked by Lavalliere. Right there in the middle of the ice, passes it back, reaches back, and the shot is off target. And now Columbus is able to regather the troops, organize their offense, and get going down the ice, pushing it into the Seawolves zone. Looks like it takes a bit of a dive. And now it's going to be another Omnitech icing call here in the Coliseum. Down to just over 3 minutes left in the second period of play. Your Seawolves finally had a good opportunity there with with Helen and Kuznetsov in front of the net. And this brings us to our final media timeout here in the second period. Welcome back here to the Wolves Den and the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Near 3 minutes left in the second period. Columbus River Dragons 2. The Mississippi Seawolves yet to score. But they're finally there the last couple minutes here in the second period. The Seawolves have been able to get the puck into the zone and got a few shots off, making Lavalier earn his money for Columbus. Seawolves talking, and I was expecting to see a lot more physicality from the Seawolves, but the River Dragons are really fast on the ice. They're able to move the puck around, they're finding space, and they're able to keep the attack and the puck in the Seawolves zone. Hopefully when they get into the break here, after the second period, the Seawolves can work it out and hopefully keep the puck more in Columbus's zone. Now this faceoff coming to Wyrick's right on the stick side. The Seawolves get possession of the puck. Even numbers on the attack. And they're not able to keep the puck. And now breakaway, McDonald by himself. Wyrick with the stick save. Now the puck is pushed past the goal line. Fighting for the puck is Anderson. And now it's deep into the Seawolves zone. Oh, slashing right across the middle of the ice was Moore for Columbus. Almost had another shot opportunity there. The Seawolves are able to clear it out of the zone. Bond sends it wide just over the net. Bond sends it across, tries to get the redirect in front of the net. Curling around is Bond. Bond trying to find some space, but the wrist shot coming from the edge of the house over there on the far side. Now on the attack. Columbus is quick down the ice. When they get possession of the puck, they are quickly moving down. Under 1.5 minutes left here in the second period. The Seawolves survive a storm. Bond by himself to get the line change. Now down against the boards, behind the Seawolves net. Seawolves win the puck, trying to get the attack together. They're still not going to be able to get numbers. Helen in the slot. The one-timer from the blue line is wide. 1 minute left to go here in the second period. Looks like we had a puck, another flying biscuit with 1 minute left to go. Let's see if the Seawolves can cut the lead in half. Fresh legs on the ice. And for the faceoff is Wong. Wong is able to win the puck. The Seawolves just dump it down. Puck is on the far side. Looks like Bond keeps it in the zone. Wickline makes the pass to the center. And now Wickline pushing hard towards the middle, but the save is made by, the stop is made by Wyrick with 33 seconds left on the clock here in the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Wyrick is looking pumped down there. Maybe we can get some more of his teammates pumped up, get some energy here, because it looks like they're running out of gas here under the final minute, and hoping the Seawolves maybe get a chance to steal a quick score here before they go in for the next break. That's something that would really help, you know, with the momentum of the game, because you don't want to just keep it close. You want to come in here and win a game. Russell is able to get the puck, headed down, pushes it to the outside. Helen is able to control the puck. Now Columbus in center ice. The dish is made to Barr with the opportunity, not able to put it home. A furious last minute here, under 5 seconds left on the clock, and it's going to bring us to the horn here, the end of your second period of play. With the score, the Columbus River Dragons and the Mississippi Seawolves 0. Now, there was some good energy there out of the Seawolves during that final mad minute. What we're going to be looking forward to is seeing some more of that in the third period of play, because while the score is 2-0, this game is not out of reach. Anything can happen, and I'm really looking forward to some aggressiveness from the Seawolves as the Twisted T Zamboni gets ready to come on to the ice. Let's once again send it to hear from some of our partners here at Seawolves Hockey.
Phil Wong and Matt Stoya here at Gulf Coast Firestone.
This is Matt Stoya with your Mississippi Seawolves at Gulf Coast Firestone, and just letting you guys know, we service all types of oil changes, AC, scheduled maintenance, brakes, front end repair, all types of tires for cars, trucks, ATVs, and trailer tires.
Hey Seawolves fans, all season ticket holders and sponsors get 15% off all services.
Open 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday through Friday, located at 4283 Pops Ferry Road in D'Iberville, Mississippi.
And don't forget to ask about our 6-month tire financing program. Only $149 down, minimal purchase, and you're good to go.
Welcome back to the Mississippi Coast Coliseum on Mississippi Seawolves Network here on YouTube. Your Mississippi Seawolves trail the Columbus River Dragons 2-0. Looking at some of the statistics in the first period, Columbus had 14 shots on goal and 13 shots on goal in the second period. And the Seawolves had 12 shots on goal in that second period. You know, as the youngsters are down here, people trying to throw pucks into the basket, you know, trying to look at the positives of the second period. They did give up a goal in the second period, 2 minutes into the period, but then the Seawolves were able to gather it together and not give up another goal. The offense, you know, when you look for the positives, the offense, though, has had a tough time getting the offense together, moving down the ice in a way in which people could get open, finding space, and we've had some good opportunities in some madness. But it looks like the offense seems a little bit disjointed. And if you were here for the pregame, it does make a little bit of sense with the number of people that have been added as they're getting the team together, getting ready to make this final push through the regular season. But we're going to wait on some more of these stats to come in from the crew here at the Coliseum. We're going to take this chance again to hear from some more of our partners here on the Seawolves Network.
Seawolves fans, it's Blake Wyrick, Phil Wong, and Matt Stoya here at Gulf Coast Firestone.
This is Matt Stoya with your Mississippi Seawolves at Gulf Coast Firestone, and just letting you guys know, we service all types of oil changes, AC, scheduled maintenance, brakes, front end repair, all types of tires for cars, trucks, ATVs, and trailer tires.
Hey Seawolves fans, all season ticket holders and sponsors get 15% off all services.
Open 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday through Friday, located at 4283 Hops Ferry Road in D'Iberville, Mississippi.
And don't forget to ask about our 6-month tire financing program. Only $149 down, minimum purchase, and you're good to go.
Back here in the Coliseum, as the little ones are out there picking up the pucks from the promotion. I know there's a lot of parents sitting in the bleachers wondering why these kids can't pick up that well at home. But they're getting the job done as we're waiting for the Zamboni to come out. And the good news is, fans, that it looks like the pipe was able to stay in the ice, and we're not going to have the repair crew out here again as the Twisted Tea Zamboni is waiting. And we look forward to seeing you out here and fans coming back out and back here on the Seawolves Network tomorrow night if you can't make it, as you're going to see the third game here in this series. The finale faceoff will be in puck drop at 7:05. But your Seawolves are not done for the weekend. They'll be back here Friday night hosting the Baton Rouge Zydeco. And we'll be celebrating St. Patrick's Day this Friday. If you look on the Facebook page, you will see the special sweaters it looks like that we're going to see. And it's celebrate St. Patrick's Day here at the Seawolves and the Puck of the Irish with the puck drop at 7:05.
Great relationships with not only the players, the staff, and everything that to do with the team. We've also built great relationships with other sponsors. One of the things we incorporated this year and we plan to keep moving forward with is a discount to other sponsors, and some other sponsors have now jumped on board and are offering discounts to us and other sponsors as well. So it's just building another community of networking, for business networking, and I believe it's helping grow small businesses here on the Gulf Coast. We'll be right back.
what's going on, Mississippi Seawolves fans? It's number 23, Jackson Bond. I'm here with number 10, Philip Wong, and number 17, Kyle Russell. And we're here today at Gulf Coast Golf Carts in Biloxi, Mississippi. It's just off of Exit 50. Come on out. They have new and used golf carts. They do services and repairs for any golf cart brand, so you can bring your own if you need anything fixed up. They're the people for you. Best prices on the coast, that's a guarantee. So come and see our friends. We appreciate all their support. We want to support them back, so come out and see them. Thanks, guys.
As spring is in the air, Seawolves fan, the season is winding down. And right now your Seawolves are sitting in fourth place in the Continental Division. They have 53 points. With those 53 points, they have a 15-point lead over the fifth place Blue Ridge Bobcats. And there are 15 games left to play. As we're here with, looks like on the clock, 9 minutes left, just under 9 minutes before we begin the third and final period here this evening. But the Seawolves, you know, hopefully this next period they are going to be able to finish strong, cut this lead in half, even it up, and then take the lead, because that's what we're going to need to do as we push through this season with these 15 games left. I'm really looking forward to a lot of positive things. And Coach Jackson, you know, Coach Skinner, he has only been here, this is just the sixth contest for the Seawolves under Coach Skinner. In his home opener, the Seawolves hit pay dirt and were able to get out and escape with an exciting win here at home against the Thunderbirds. That was back in the middle of February. But since then, the Seawolves have been unable to break into the win column. They did go into overtime in one of those ball games, but they weren't able to get the win in overtime. And so, you know, we've seen a lot of change in the Seawolves. If you go online, you can see the transaction wire, and I discussed it in the pregame show, that there's a lot of change here, and the Seawolves are settling in, and hopefully, as we get ready to go here in the third quarter, we'll see some more of that action. And once again, looking forward to some energy coming from the Seawolves as they come into this third period, because it's going to take that, because they're going to need to spend more time down in Columbus's zone. And as we're getting close to the end of this break, once again, let's hear from some of our partners here on the Seawolves Network.
Seawolves fans, it's Blake Wyrick, Phil Wong, and Matt Stoya here at Gulf Coast Firestone.
This is Matt Stoya with your Mississippi Seawolves at Gulf Coast Firestone, and just letting you guys know, we service all types of oil changes, AC, scheduled maintenance, brakes, front end repair, all types of tires for cars, trucks, ATVs, and trailer tires.
Hey, Seawolves fans, all season ticket holders and sponsors, you get 15% off all services.
Open 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., Monday through Friday, located at 4283 Hops Ferry Road in D'Iberville, Mississippi.
And don't forget to ask about our 6-month tire financing program. Only $149 down, minimal purchase, and you're good to go.
Here we go. Pinball Republic Seawolves down here. Woo! Having a blast. This is so intense. So much fun. So I can't wait to get back out there. Let's go. This is just chill.
Back here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum, the Zamboni making it looks like its final pass around the ice. The Mississippi Seawolves looking to put some pressure on Columbus. The defense has not been able to keep them from getting a lot of open shots because too many times tonight, if you look down on the ice, that the Columbus forwards are wide open with nobody nearby. They've been able to do it. They've done a good job of finding space and being able to get those shots off. But Wyrick, in his first game back, we are going to see him do a wonderful job. Now, I know there's two pucks have gone past him, but this evening it's been quite the adventure. Just up here in the press box, it's just continual pressure on Wyrick in the crease, and the Seawolves are able to get that pressure there at the end of the third at the end of the second period. But the horn is sounding, asking the teams to come back out, as we're now down under 3 minutes. Still haven't seen the referees come out. I'm going to be able to look down at the computer at this, because usually you get some boos or the Bronx cheers from the crowd when the officials come out. Let's send it back one more time for our partners here on the Seawolves Network.
When injury knocks you out, Bienville Orthopedic Specialists will be there for you every step of the way. We are here to get you back in the game, back in motion, back to your life. Our elite team of orthopedic specialists will work side by side with you, educating you about your treatment plan, utilizing advanced technology, and providing you with a successful path to recovery. Bienville Orthopedic Specialists. We will get you back.
OmniTech is an American-based MSP. We're a multiple service provider. We provide IT supports, telephone systems, especially specializing in VoIP, voice over IP services, and electronic security protection, such as alarm systems, surveillance systems, and access control systems. Basically, we try to be your one-stop shop for all your technical needs, and we want to just keep you connected.
Seawolves are heading out to get loose and warm for this final period of play here in the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. The score, after two complete, Columbus River Dragons 2, your Mississippi Seawolves 0. Tonight there's only been one power play opportunity. They had one Gulf Coast Firestone power play opportunity, and the Seawolves were not able to capitalize on that. That took place at the end of the first period. In the second period, it seemed like Wyrick was under assault in the crease most of the period as the puck was down in his zone, but it looks like he's ready and coming back out. If the camera panned to him, you'd see him scarring up in front of his crease. He's had quite the night here, in my opinion. But of course, with shots on goal on the score sheet, I got shots on goal, the River Dragons 27 and your Mississippi Seawolves 20. And Lavalier has done a good job in the crease for the River Dragons. And, you know, that defensive play that he is able to put out there is one of the reasons that the River Dragons only have four losses on the year. And the River Dragons seem poised to make a championship run, but I know your Mississippi Seawolves are going to want to stop that, because coming out of the playoffs as a four seed, we'll probably see them again not too long into the playoffs. Let's take a look at the possible playoff brackets here in the FPHL, see how it works in the divisions. But like I mentioned earlier, your Seawolves are sitting in the fourth spot, that last playoff spot. And let's see if they can steal some points here in this third period to try to get some points and create some more space. And back at center ice is Wong for your Mississippi Seawolves for the drop of the puck. And we're away in the third period. And there's our first OmniTech icing here with under 10 seconds into the period. But with that icing call, the Seawolves are going to be forced back deep into the zone as Columbus is looking for opportunities to continue to put pressure on Wyrick. And now we have one of those opportunities with Bond by himself, sends it across the crease, but nobody there. And now Columbus is moving the puck into the Seawolves zone. Wong again with the pucks, with the pass across the ice. Nielsen received the pass. And we're going to see a stoppage in play here again. Both teams are going to take the opportunity for the line change. Headed in for the drop is Barr, right there on the dot here on the near side. The River Dragons are able to take possession of the puck. There, the pass is intercepted by the Seawolves. See if they can get something going here with 19 minutes left to go in the match. Pushes across the blue line, going to try to keep it in the zone, and they're not able to do so. And so now the Seawolves are about to set up again. It looks like there's a little bit of fire underneath them with a bit of pressure. Now we're going to look and see if it appears the Columbus may be sitting on their laurels a little bit, moving the puck around, keeping the puck here at center ice. Now they're going to send it down into the zone for an opportunity for a line change. You're also going to see fresh skaters on the ice for the Seawolves. Stoya with the puck. As the offense tries to come together. And the pass is going to be intercepted. Man, the shot is wide. And it is cleared. Push it down into the Portillo. Slides it across the slot, but nobody was home. Stoya once again. Tonic with the puck, and Wyrick is going to cover up the puck. Here we have less than 18 minutes to go in the game. Your Seawolves trail Columbus 2-0. Long in for the faceoff. Looks like he gets it out there to Lind, and now the Seawolves are on the attack. The shot is going to be wide. Almost kept it in the zone. Trying to get the one-on-one opportunity. They're not able to get there. Squares up, gets the shot off. Melee in the crease. And now it looks like we have a Gulf Coast wrestling fight here as they go into the boards. It got started, but it not much was able to happen. And the tussle right there for your Seals, and a little extracurriculars on the way to the box. 7:22 left in the game. See if this will light a fire under the Seawolves. After a lot of poking and slashing and pressure on his goalie, you're going to see the Seawolves stand up for Wyrick because he's done a heck of a job tonight. Both players are going to be in the box for 4 minutes. That was Russell there on the boards. Going to be in the box for 4 minutes here as both teams are going to be down to four men. Conversations taking place as they're trying to get the offense together. That's a PA is trying to get the crowd going. Russell did his job on the boards, and let's see what the rest of the Seawolves can do. Anderson for Columbus is able to control the puck. And it wasn't technically called a fight. The penalties were officially roughing. Four-man squads are going to be out there for only 2 minutes. Pushing up is Bond. Now the puck. It's going to be controlled by Columbus. Passes it off. Stoya sends it across the middle. Wong isn't able to control it. Now it's going to be right there at center. Isis Lynn. Stoya is once again with the puck, trying to get the offense together. Get some attackers going down. He's got a man going down the center, not able to get the puck to him, but off the boards. Hauls it into the corner. Now back in on center ice, trying to get one more chance here with the low numbers. Under 40 minutes left with the penalties, or 40 seconds left with the penalties.
And Columbus slows it down. See if they can find an opportunity. McDonald puts pressure on Nielsen. Helen with the puck. Crosses the blue line. Gets it to Barr. Barr looks with a little flip shot. Wide of the net to the right. Hasselin gets it to the middle. Little extra action there after the puck was gone. Seems like it's getting a little chippy here in the third period. McDonald with the puck at center ice. Looked like he was going to dump it in. Waiting for his guys to get offside, and Weirich makes the save with that 15:02 in the third period. As you see, the Seawolves getting a little bit more aggressive as time is winding down. You can see Columbus responding with a little bit of physicality. Looking forward to the Seawolves responding with some physicality. And I'm sure Coach Jackson is going to be looking for that as well. Columbus wins the faceoff. Able to find Doe in the circle. Gets it right there in the middle. One-timer. Too high as the biscuit is in the bleachers. Flying biscuit as the youngin is over there trying to track it down. Now that's going to bring us to our media timeout here, our first media timeout here in the third period as we hear from our partners here at Seawolves Hockey.
Hey, what's going on, Mississippi Seawolves fans? It's number 23, Jackson Bond. I'm here with number 10, Philip Wong, and number 17, Kyle Russell. And we're here today at Gulf Coast Golf Carts in Biloxi, Mississippi. It's just off of Exit 50. Come on out. They have new and used golf carts. They do services and repairs for any golf cart brand, so you can bring your own if you need anything fixed up. They're the people for you. Best prices on the coast. That's a guarantee. So come and see our friends. We appreciate all their support. We want to support them back. So come out and see them. Thanks, guys.
Back here in the Mississippi Coast Coliseum, third period of play. Your Mississippi Seawolves trail Columbus 2-0. So far here in the third period, two shots on goal for each team. The faceoff is going to happen to Weirich's right. Again, out of the faceoff, Columbus is able to control the puck. The official gets in the way, and Barr is headed down the ice. He squeezes in between two defenders, not able to get a true shot off on goal. And a whistle from the officials. It does appear in this third period of play, the Seawolves are moving with a sense of purpose. Bond headed in for the faceoff here. Try to find a shot opportunity. And score! Bond from the high slot is able to put it in the back of the net. Anderson won the faceoff. Bond put it in. That looks like it's going to put some life in the crowd here in Mississippi Coast Coliseum as well as the Seawolves. As they cut Columbus's lead in half. 10,
Wall. Assisted by number 23, Jackson Bond. Time in the goal, 5:37 of the third period. Seawolves goal scored by 10, assists by 23, 5:37 of the third.
Seawolves now trying to attempting to get it into the zone. Wolves on the story on the attack with the slap shot near the blue line. High of the mark. Good push it to the wall there. They call for the line change. Bond headed to the bench after he got that assist on that goal. And they dump it in, and Wyrick is able to get it into his glove. Life here in the Mississippi Coast Coliseum, as this next faceoff is going to happen to Wyrick's stick side, the near side here. Columbus lining up, swings the puck across the slot, not able to have anybody there to put it home. Now McDonald in the high slot. Not bounces off Wyrick. Now at the boards again. Little action there from Aslan. Aslan again behind the net. A pressure on McDonald. Dumps it back. McWill and Wyrick puts his skates down. Puck caroms off. Seawolves looking for numbers. Russell gets it over there to Licio, but now line change. Get some fresh skates on the ice. Helen tracks the puck down, but that's another Gulf Coast, an Omnitech icing. Faceoff is going to happen to Lavaliers, right? Looks like coming in for the faceoff is Justin Barr. The Seawolves scored off the faceoff last time, hoping to do the same thing. Play is whistled dead. Barr stays in the circle. Puck ends up behind the defense, and Columbus dumps it down to the far side. And another Omnitech icing here. So we're 12:20 left to go in the contest. Now, it seemed like as the third period kicked off that Columbus was going to rest on their laurels a little bit. But now after that goal by the Seawolves, we are going to see, looks like Columbus is moving with a little bit more urgency, hoping they don't get an equalizer from the Seawolves. Helen over there in front of the Columbus bench. It appears there's not going to be much backing down here by these Seawolves. Looks like they've got some fight in them.
What y'all think about Helen?
Once again, face off to Lavaliers, right? Bar in for the Seawolves. Puck is dropped. Seawolves get possession of the ball. Shot saved by Lavaliers. Now fight for the puck here on the near side. Stoya gets the puck, sends it to the middle ice. Kuznetsov trying to find somebody to pass it to. Kuznetsov once again dumps it down into the zone. Under 12 minutes left to go in this contest. Russell with the puck. Now that puck's on the far side. As the attack gets organized, we see a crosser coming. That was Bond looking for the puck. Wasn't quite able to get there. Oh, Seawolves are able to keep it in the zone. And now Columbus, as they pushes it into the Seawolves zone. Big change for Columbus. Russell passes it to the far side. Back to the near side to Russell. Trying to find Bond in space. Sends it back to the far side of the ice. Long with the puck. It's Russell coming across the middle. Not able to get a good handle on the puck. Stoya heads across the blue line, pushes it back. Oh, just out of reach of his teammate. Now Columbus is on the attack. Seawolves weren't able to get control of the puck. Now Columbus sets up. Wyrick was there off the carom. Columbus is able to get control of the puck. Oh, there's a turnover in Columbus. Columbus's zone. All knotted up against the boards here on the near side. Trying to find somebody in open space. And I believe now they're on a breakaway. And Wyrick is able to keep the puck from finding the back of the net again. By himself, McDonald on this side. And the pass is going to be intercepted by Pertilla. Now on the far side of the ice, it is going to be dumped in. A line change. Helen there with a lot of spunk for the Seawolves. Passes behind Moore. Back to the middle. Seawolves into the zone. And Barr, off the rebound, gets another shot at it up over the net. 8:50 left to go in this contest. Now at the blue line is Helen. The defender blocks that shot. Now Helen tied up, all in the boards. Barr tries to find it, and not able to get the shot off. Hasselin, and we're going to have a whistle. And it looks like call is going to be offside. 8:20 left to go in this contest. And that whistle, after that offside, just brings us to our media timeout here to hear from our partners here at Mississippi Seawolves Hockey.
Hey Seawolves fans, it's Blake Wyrick, Phil Wong, and Matt Stoya here at Gulf Coast Firestone.
This is Matt Stoya with your Mississippi Seawolves at Gulf Coast Firestone, and just letting you guys know, we service all types of oil changes, AC, scheduled maintenance, brakes, front end repair, all types of tires for cars, trucks, ATVs, and trailer tires.
Hey Seawolves fans, all season ticket holders and sponsors get 15% off all services.
Open 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday through Friday, located at 4283 Pops Ferry Road in D'Iberville, Mississippi.
And don't forget to ask about our 6-month tire financing program. Only $149 down, minimum purchase, and you're good to go. Thank you.
Less than 10 minutes left in this contest. The crew here getting the crowd fired up on the faceoff. It looks like Columbus is going to be able to gain possession of the puck. Stoya dumps it back off the wall. Nilsson moves it forward, but turnover for the Seawolves. Long chasing the puck deep into the Columbus zone. Nilsson puts a little bit of pressure. Skates past Bond. They have a two-on-two. Not able to get it right there in the zone. By himself, McDonald behind the crease. Wyrick has his head on a swivel. Wolves not able to clear it out of the zone. Up against the boards. Matanok over there scrumming it up. Fresh here with the Seawolves. Bond dumps it down for the line change for your Seawolves. 7 minutes left to go. On the clock here in the Coliseum. The clock on the feed is a little bit behind. Now here, as time winds down in the third period, Columbus is spending more time in the Seawolves zone. Martello with the puck out to center ice. But once again, Columbus is able to gain control and they dump it in for a line change themselves. Russell with the puck sends it up to Portillo. Let the Seawolves dump it. Line change, and now Columbus is moving with pace. McDonald dumps the puck. Coming across. Not able to squeeze the pass in there. The defender is there for Columbus. Now Stoya is in the spot. Stop the pass. And Wyrick with another glove save this evening. Now, this third period of play, the number of shots have been down significantly for Columbus. It is almost even. Columbus has 7 shots on goal. Your Mississippi Seawolves 5. And, you know, they were able to put it in the back of the net at one time. And looking for the equalizer here as we're getting down to close to 6 minutes left in the contest. And Wong loses his stick, heads to the bench to get another one. Looks like Columbus is doing a little bit of stalling here. So they try to hold on to that 1-point lead. As we're now under 6 minutes left to go as in this contest. On the scoreboard here in the Coliseum, it says 5-17. Face off to Wyrick's left. Columbus wins the puck. Able to keep it in the zone. McDonald wraps it around behind the net. That's pitcher Antonio wrapped it around the net. And now one-on-one in front of the goal is Hunter. Wyrick was able to stem the attack off the rebound. A lot of pressure coming from Columbus. Seawolves are able to weather that storm. And now let's see if the Mississippi can get its attack together. Portillo pushes it down. Licio with the puck. Line change for your Seawolves. Aslan with the puck. Now hands it off to Helen. Crosses in to the blue line. Looks for somebody in the slot. Nobody was home. The puck was where it needed to be. And the defender slowed down the attack and kept him from getting there. Under 4 minutes left to go in this contest. Starting to sense, you know, here's Kuznetsov. Shot is wide of the net. And the puck clears the zone. Seawolves try to set up their offense. Pushing it here on the near side. Bersani with the wrister covered up by Wyrick. Still over 3 minutes left to go in the contest. And that brings us to our final media timeout of the period with 3:25 left on the clock here in the Coliseum. Columbus 2, your Mississippi Seawolves 1.
OmniTech is an American-based MSP. We are a multiple service provider. We provide IT support, telephone systems, especially specializing in VoIP, voice over IP services, and electronic security protection such as alarm systems, surveillance systems, and access control systems. Basically, we try to be your one-stop shop for all your technical needs, and we want to just keep you connected.
.321 left in the contest. Pepping some the step of the Seawolves as they're behind the net. Well, action right there. Bond fighting for the puck. Keeping it in the zone is Russell. Wong hits it back as the Seawolves get back on side. Bond tries to set up the attack. Nielsen in the corner, but Columbus is able to get the puck. They're able to get on sides here. Headed down. Nobody there in the slot for the pass. As the Seawolves set up their offense. 2:37 left in the contest. Stoya had the puck, but it was taken. You know, the River Dragons defense has been stout this evening. The one goal the Seawolves were able to get came off a faceoff, and they're able to sneak it in there. There. Good movement. Not able to get off the one-timer, but Kuznetsov was able to put the shot up, but it was wide of the net. Kuznetsov dumps it in. Right there, it looks like Barr at the boards. Helen fighting for the puck. Under 2 minutes left to go. Russell dumps it in. I'm sorry, that's Russell now here on the near side. But Columbus is able to clear the puck out. And with the extra person, I was busy puck watching and did not see that Weigel was pulled out of the net. And with 1:26 left to go in the contest, they were able to get a long one. The Columbus River Dragons are on the empty net as the Seawolves were pressing the issue. Now Weirich is back out in the net. That pushes the score here with about a minute and 26 seconds left. Columbus River Dragons 3, your Mississippi Seawolves 1. Anderson there on the faceoff. Columbus looks like he's going to solo dump here. And the officials are calling. One of the players are coming in for the faceoff. Looks like we're getting a little stall from the River Dragons. Just over 1 minute left to go in the contest. That's Slim fighting on the boards. Seawolves still unable to clear the zone. Under 1 minute to go. Anderson chasing the puck down. And he's able to complete the pass. Here to the near side is Portillo. Tries to center it. Sends it across over the boards. Under 40 seconds left in the contest. Columbus is going to hold the puck behind the net. There come the Seawolves to press the issue. Helen has Columbus appears to be happy to run the clock out here in the third period of play. And the puck crosses center eye down less than 10 seconds. And that is going to do it for tonight's contest. Your final score, the Columbus River Dragons 3 and your Mississippi Seawolves 1. Once again, fans, we'd like to thank you for joining us here on the Seawolves Network. I'm Harold Rose. I've been filling in tonight for Javik Blake. There's our big shoes to fill, and I'd like to thank you for tolerating me this evening. The final score, Columbus 3, your Seawolves 1. As we're waiting to hear on the stars of the game, at the story of tonight, it seemed like a lack of offensive production, of course, with one goal tonight for the Seawolves. And, when in the third period, when they were moving with a sense of purpose, they were able to put pressure on. But for the first two periods, it seemed like most of the contest was in their own zone. And Weirich had his back up against the wall. The final count tonight, 38 shots on goal for Columbus. Your Seawolves had 25. Your third star tonight of the game went to one of your Seawolves, Mr. Philip Wong. This came over the came over the intercom. And we look forward to seeing you here tomorrow night here at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum for the third and final game in the series, as the Columbus River Dragons will be back for the 11th and final game, I believe possibly the final game between these two teams. There might be one more. We'll have to tell you good night from the Mississippi Coast Coliseum.
We have built great relationships with not only the players, the staff, and everything that to do with the team. We've also built great relationships with other sponsors. One of the things we incorporated this year and we plan to keep moving forward with is a discount to other sponsors. And some other sponsors have now jumped on board and are offering discounts to us and other sponsors as well. So it's just building another community of networking for business networking. And I believe it's helping grow small businesses here on the Gulf Coast.